I saw this pastor promote basically a metaverse church where people can go to church, not just online. So you're not just watching a sermon online. I don't know if you saw this or not, but you're basically like a Sims character where you see your character on the screen going in and sitting down, congregating with people, having, you know, digital coffee and things like that. And I mean, we're not talking about progressives here. We are talking about people who probably see themselves as conservative evangelicals praising this and saying, this is great. I guess I get it on the one hand, like you are using whatever means possible to reach people. On the other hand, my thought is, okay, how can you really fellowship, get to know people, hold people accountable for their sin, encourage one another, take communion, baptize one another through the metaverse, which are all commands that we are given in Scripture? What do you think about that?
So much of this is the local church is God's primary entry point of discipleship, of discipling the nations. It's the primary contact point to the world is the local church. And that is a very tangible transaction. We are materialistic beings on a spiritual path. We require, therefore, a materialistic, natural connection. That's why going back to, you know, you quoting from the New Testament there, Emmanuel, God with us. That's why God came here. And before that, he physically manifested himself as pillars of smoke, burning bushes, consuming fires, because he sent the Holy Spirit to individual prophets, because we require that level of tangible connection as materialistic beings in a fallen world. The idea that we would now just remove that, and we wouldn't do that, by the way, for some, you know, pietistic, spiritual, hyper-spiritual conversation that we can have, is this moving us to a place of deeper spirituality, but instead for further convenience, again, to make it easy to participate, that to me, I just find, I find that every bit as threatening, frankly, as open heresy. At least with an open heresy, I can confront it head on. At least with an open heresy, St. Nicholas can get up at the Council of Nicaea and pimp slap Arius a couple of times, okay? With this kind of, and that literally happened, by the way, for people that want to know what I'm referencing. With this kind of softened heretical or unorthodoxy or deorthodoxy, maybe is a better word, to me, that's even more threatening, because there's a reason why we're warned against wolves in sheep's clothing and not wolves. When you see the fangs and claws of a wolf, you instinctively know what to do as a person. It's when it comes dressed, when it shows up at Little Red Riding Hood's house, and it's dressed in grandmother's garb, that's when you let it in.
I also think about the fact that the church is the bride of Christ, and in the same way that you wouldn't have a metaverse marriage, it seems to me that right. It's just as illogical that you would be able to have a metaverse true relationship with the church. It just doesn't work like that. If God wanted us to exist digitally, he would have created us that way, but he did create us in the flesh, and as you said so well, Jesus is God made flesh. So that to me tells us something about how we are to interact with one another as the body of Christ. We're also called the body of Christ. There are so many different parts
of this. We're not the avatar of Christ?
Right.
Yeah, we're not? Right. Okay. We're exactly. Not the screenshot of Christ? We're the body of Christ. Okay, cool. Yeah.
If you enjoyed this video, hit like and subscribe to our channel so you'll be sure to see similar videos from Blaze TV, with the added bonus of signaling YouTube that your voice and opinion still matters. And if you're looking for more great conservative content, check out one of the two videos suggested here. And let's go, Brandon.